Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this video we are going to know about Heldon effect. So what is Heldon effect? We'll be talking about its introduction, about its mechanism, and also about the significances of Heldon effect. So regarding carbon dioxide transport, there are three main ways of carbon dioxide transport. One, in its dissolved state, that accounts for 7% of the total carbon dioxide transported as bicarbonate, that we discussed in our earlier video in the chloride shift topic, that is maximum, so it's 63%, and with combination with hemoglobin and plasma proteins, that accounts for the remaining 30% of the carbon dioxide transported. So this thing here is hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a tetrapeptide that is composed of four peptide chains, two alpha chains and two beta chains. And the thing I have shown here in between this hemoglobin is carbon dioxide. This blue circle represents carbon dioxide. In Heldon effect, we are going to see pictorially in an animated model what is Heldon effect. So these are red circular spheres, these are the oxygen. So we are going to see what Heldon effect is. So Heldon effect is basically concerned with the interaction between the oxygen, carbon dioxide and hemoglobin. Okay, now we'll see what it is. So when oxygen molecule, they bind to hemoglobin, the carbon dioxide molecule that was originally bound to hemoglobin is released. So Heldon effect is as simple as this. So Heldon effect is when oxygen molecules bind to hemoglobin, carbon dioxide molecule is released. We can also say it in this in another way, as when the partial pressure of oxygen in the blood increases, the carbon dioxide molecules attached to the hemoglobin is released, or it facilitates the release of carbon dioxide. In this way, Heldon effect facilitates the transport of carbon dioxide. Okay, so now we are going to see the mechanism behind this Heldon effect. Now, next thing about the mechanism. Now, once more, when oxygen molecules, they bind to the hemoglobin. So what happens now that causes the carbon dioxide to remove now, or carbon dioxide to be released? Now we're going to talk about that thing. So when this happens, when oxygen molecule bind to hemoglobin, hemoglobin becomes more acidic, that causes it to release S plus ions. Okay, so these S plus ions bind to bicarbonate to form carbonic acid. Carbonic acid then splits into water and releases carbon dioxide molecules. So this is the mechanism behind Heldon effect. So we knew what Heldon effect is, and the mechanism is when oxygen molecules bind to hemoglobin, this causes hemoglobin to become more acidic, that releases S plus ions that bind to bicarbonate to form carbonic acid that ultimately breaks down to release water and carbon dioxide. So in this way, carbon dioxide is released. Another mechanism that can be proposed here is when the binding of oxygen to hemoglobin occurs, it reduces the affinity for carbon dioxide molecules, so facilitating its release. Now let's see this thing graphically. In this graph, we are going to see the significance of Heldon effect. So what happens due to Heldon effect? Okay, so here I'm going to show you a carbon dioxide dissociation curve, a portion of carbon dioxide dissociation curve. So this is a portion of carbon dioxide dissociation curve. Along the y-axis is the volume percentage of carbon dioxide in the blood, and along the x-axis is the partial pressure of carbon dioxide in millimeter of mercury. So what happens in this curve? Now we are going to analyze this curve. Okay, so usually the partial pressure of carbon dioxide inside the body exists in between the 40 to 45 mm of Hg. So this curve depends on the partial pressure of oxygen. So we will just see this later. So this curve was drawn at the partial pressure of oxygen when it was 40 mm of mercury. So this pressure of oxygen exists in the tissue capillaries. So in the tissue capillaries, the partial pressure of oxygen is 40 mm of Hg. So regarding the partial pressure of carbon dioxide in body, it varies between 40 to 45. So 45 in the tissue capillaries and 40 in the pulmonary capillaries. So we are going to analyze this curve. When the partial pressure of carbon dioxide in the blood, that is in the tissue capillaries, 45, then it corresponds to 52% of carbon dioxide in the blood, meaning by if the blood is 100 100 ml, then the volume of carbon dioxide in that blood would be 52 ml. So in the when the partial pressure of carbon dioxide in the blood is 40 mmHg, that is in the pulmonary capillaries, there would be 2% less carbon dioxide in the blood, meaning by 50 mmHg. So we are going to see the difference in volume percent of carbon dioxide equals 52 minus 50, that equals 2%. So this would be the amount of carbon dioxide transported between the tissue capillaries and pulmonary capillaries, or this would be the amount of, it should be the volume of carbon dioxide transported if there was no Heldon effect. Let's say it this way. Okay, so now we'll see what would be the effect of Heldon effect on this curve. We can see the curve has shifted. Okay, the shift is due to the Heldon effect, and we can see this curve now is drawn when the partial pressure of oxygen is 100 mmHg, that is in the pulmonary capillary. So we can see this time when the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 40 mmHg, the corresponding volume percentage of blood, volume percentage of carbon dioxide in the blood is 48. This causes the difference to become from 52 to 48, that is it would be 4%. Okay, so difference in the volume percentage of carbon dioxide this time is 4%. Now we can compare this with the previous one when it was only 2%. So here it is the significance of the Heldon effect. Okay, so due to Heldon effect, what has happened is the difference in volume percentage of carbon dioxide has doubled. So this double would result in the transport of double volume of carbon dioxide, because first the difference was only 2%, now this time the difference is 4%. So this would cause in the doubling of the volume of carbon dioxide transported. So conversely, it can also be said that it would also result in increased or doubled pickup of carbon dioxide from the tissues. So this is the significance of Heldon effect. Okay, so we have talked in this video, we have talked about introduction of Heldon effect, we have also talked about the mechanism of Heldon effect, and finally we did a graphical analysis on the Heldon effect. So hope you have become clear on this topic. And at the end, I would like to say that Heldon effect is reverse of Bohr's effect. Okay, so if you want to know what Bohr's effect is, you will have to wait for the next video. Thank you everyone for joining with me in this video. If you have any query regarding the topic, please let me know in the comment sections below. And if you think this video was worthy, then please like, give a share, and also subscribe so that you don't miss the upcoming videos. And yes, also please click on the bell icon. So see you in the next video. Thank you.